Good evening, everyone. Max Olson here with your AdjusterTV Tropical Update. Breaking news overnight as tropical storm ISAIAS becomes a hurricane just off the coast of Hispaniola, where it's heading and potential strength and impacts. But first, an overview of Hurricane Hanna, which hit the Texas coast last weekend. Hurricane Hanna came as a bit of a surprise. It was originally not expected to develop into much, maybe a tropical depression or storm. But the conditions ended up being just favorable enough for it to strengthen rapidly before making landfall. Thankfully for the residents, the hurricane made landfall over primarily unpopulated areas between Corpus Christi and Brownsville. Port Mansfield, where we watched the hurricane, only has a population of about 200 to 300 people. Now on to ISAIAS. This storm has rapidly strengthened after getting off of Hispaniola. It's possible that it's actually been a hurricane for longer than we've known because we don't have proper data sources out there, so we had to wait for the hurricane hunters to go in and investigate. Currently, it's expected to remain a Category 1 hurricane as it rides up the coastline, potentially making landfall somewhere on the eastern seaboard. Currently, models have it skirting just off the coast of Florida, though just a few days ago, it was making a potential run at a landfall over Florida, so there is still time to fluctuate. However, as the storm begins to strengthen and a center is completely established, the models are going to get a bit better handle on where this thing is going. And you can see here on what we call the spaghetti plots, they are kind of getting more tightly oriented over a certain track. Now, this still can and will change, but we are starting to see the likelihood of a potential landfall in North Carolina start to increase, so that we're going to be watching that very, very carefully, because ultimately this storm has quite a bit of time to intensify. It's going to encounter some shear over the next few days that may limit it, but once it makes that shot to the north, it definitely is going to have potential for some intensification, potentially even making a run at a Category 2. Now that's it for now. We don't want to go into any more specifics because the storm is still developing its inner core, and until it does that, it's kind of like throwing darts at a board. We do have some general consensus as to where this thing's probably going to be heading, but ultimately we don't want to make any predictions as far as landfall points other than what's already been mentioned currently. There's a lot of uncertainty over the next few days, so stay tuned here. We'll try and do another update before this thing makes landfall, and if it does appear to continue to intensify, I will be heading out to the eastern seaboard wherever it ends up looking like it'll make landfall. If it even does, there's still obviously potential this thing just curves off and goes out to sea. So we don't want to make any promises right now. All that you should know is you need to stay alert if you're on the eastern coast. If you're an adjuster in the area, be on alert. Call your firms now if you need some additional training. Now is the time to do it. Head on over to adjustertv.com/book and iapath.com for training resources for adjusters.